Take jihad. What causes jihad? Is it poverty? If so, shouldn't we see jihad among all poor people, whether Muslim or not? Is Islam the cause? If it were, wouldn't everyone who believes in Islam be a jihadist? One-dimensional explanations won't help us understand jihad because it isn't the result of one factor. It's the result of three. If you're missing any of the three factors, the new dimension doesn't emerge. But when all three come together, they form what we'll call the jihad triangle. First factor, belief in Islam. To become a jihadist, you have to believe that there is no God but Allah, that Muhammad is his messenger, and that you have access to the commands of Allah and Muhammad. Islam is foundational because if you don't believe in Allah, you're not going to wage jihad for him. You might fight for other things, but it won't be jihad. Second factor, knowledge of what Islam commands. You can believe in Islam without knowing that Allah commands Muslims to fight those who do not believe in Allah, or that Muhammad declared, "I've been ordered to fight people till they say there is no God but Allah." When I quote these passages to westernized Muslims, they generally have no clue what I'm talking about, even though I'm quoting Allah and Muhammad. But the jihadist is familiar with these kinds of passages, so jihadists aren't merely Muslims. They're Muslims who know that they've been commanded to violently subjugate unbelievers. Third factor, obedience. The world is filled with people who choose the path of least resistance, people who do whatever makes them feel most comfortable. But some people are wired differently. They are willing to do whatever they believe is right, regardless of the consequences. You can kill them, they won't back down. This character trait, when combined with certain noble values, gives rise to heroes, men and women who will lay down their lives to help others. But when it's combined with belief in Islam and knowledge of Allah's commands, it results in obedience and a willingness to fight the unbelievers and the hypocrites and be unyielding to them.